Fever.
Universal Pictures presents Jungle Fever, a film about two people who discover each other and the harsh realities of love and racial conflict.
This film's about an interracial couple. It's set today in a contemporary New York, a young black architect from Harlem, and through circumstances finds himself in a relationship with a young white Italian-American woman from Bensonhurst.
The world of Angela Tucci, played by Annabella Sciorra, is Bensonhurst. The world of Flipper Purify, played by Wesley Snipes, is Harlem. Two people coming from different worlds, destined to collide.
Yes, I do have a problem, to be honest with you. Fake Italian brothers like you coming in here, that's so typical. I can't even believe you brought her stringy here.
It's not your business who I bring in here.
Somewhere else.
It's not your business. You are a waitress. Your job is to wait.
Oh, it's like that, right?
That's the
fine. You get more. I'll get my manager for you.
You're fired!
What about children?
No, that's not what
I'm saying, if we work it out.
No children.
You might not get any stairs in the village, but interracial couple walks in Harlem and Bensonhurst are definitely to get stairs. For me, in this film, this is the myth we're trying to explore. The myth of the white female being the epitome of beauty, the standard beauty in the world. And for the black male, the myth that the black male has always been, always will be this sexual super, you know, Superman stud.
I'm seeing somebody.
Yeah?
Yeah.
It's Susanna?
Who are you seeing?
Somebody from work.
That new job?
Yeah.
That was quick.
Very fancy place.
And what is he, like blonde, blue-eyed surfer type?
Hey, dude.
Right? Who is that?
He's black. What's the matter? Black? Is that your face?
Did it with a black guy?
Some people think
she
goes for this guy because it's taboo and because she's always been told not to, and I've never ever seen it like that. He just touches something in her. He opens up a little world or a possibility maybe of this other world that exists. You know, sometimes somebody can just, you know, touch you physically or whatever, and you bloom a little bit, and then you bloom a little bit more, and you want to explore that.
46 apples take 3 months.
Once the relationship between Angela and Flipper becomes public, they must deal with the ultimate personal rejections, that of their own families. A confrontational dinner at the home of Flipper's parents, played by veteran actors Ruby Dee and Ossie Davis, makes both lovers realize the challenges ahead.
Well, has Flipper told you about his loving wife and daughter?
Yes, yes.
Excuse me.
You think I don't understand about the white woman committing black adultery, but I do.
Now, Daddy, no sermons, please.
As for the black man, like my own son, Flipper, who ought to know better, got a loving wife and daughter, still got to fish in the white man's cesspool. I have nothing but contempt. Excuse me. I don't eat with whoremongers.
He refuses to have dinner with them. He starts out as his wife, orders him, but the good reverend doctor goes as far as he can. But he cannot bring himself to break that bread in the end. It's too far beyond it.
I think the conversation that Flipper and Angie have coming home from dinner with their father, he's just been kind of disowned in a roundabout way. And the effects are so strong that it could cause two people who may not be at odds at one another to get disillusioned with what the problem is. They will think it's each other, when in reality, it's the pressure of the circumstances that's being put upon them.
Let me have a glass.
Why don't you say please?
I'm not gonna say please. That's not gonna stop me from being angry.
Get your hands up! Get your hands up!
Back away!
Get your hands up! Now!
Get back!
Move!
Please separate
yourself! Get to the wall! Get to the wall, man! Get to the wall!
Let go of me! That's my boyfriend! That's my lover, Mr.
Look, just shut up! Just shut up, all right?
He wasn't trying to rape you!
Assault! No!
No!
A bitch!
big misunderstanding. That's all it is.
Dig, let me do that. Let me see you do it without opening up the door, just so we can see you through the glass.
The film was shot entirely on New York locations, including Harlem and the Italian community of Bensonhurst. Teaming with director Lee for the third time is John Turturro. Turturro plays Paulie, the scorned lover of Angela Tucci.
I'm not a man. I'm a woman. But my brother's pick, I mean, I could deal with it. When they pick, I knew. He just said that you grant and you take it.
With all due respect, the two brothers of his time.
Yeah.
I think him and Angie are, you know, close, but maybe not the perfect people for each other. But they definitely, you know, he cares about her. And of course, in the movie, that's his whole world. And then she leaves him. It's probably the only woman he's ever been with, or knew, or anything.
Mindy, Newsday.
Papa, I wanted the same number every day, and every day you ask me the same question.
I don't know.
You do know. It never changes.
Are you kidding? Newspapers change every day.
Legendary actor Anthony Quinn, appearing in his 271st film, plays Paulie's domineering and possessive father, Lou Carbone.
Hey. Gonna say goodbye to your mother? He's using life as an excuse to exist. He doesn't live, he exists. I like him, I like the character very much because he's so ignorant and so prejudiced without knowing that he is prejudiced.
Action!
Do you have hopes and aspirations for films? I guess you can only hope and aspire that the stuff you want happens, happens. And you just hope for the best.
Spike Lee's Jungle Fever, a controversial journey into personal relationships destined to be one of the most talked about films of the summer from Universal Pictures, starring Wesley Snipes, Annabella Sciorra, Anthony Quinn, and Spike Lee.
He's got jungle fever, I got jungle fever, he got jungle fever, here we go.
Oh,